All right, what is going on, my dude? So, about a day or two ago, Marvel Contest of Champions released this really awesome update to the state of the Battle Realm picture on Twitter, and a bunch of people have commented on my videos being like, yo, what do you think about the new thing? I'll show you the full thing, by the way. So I'll hide my face here for a second, just in case you guys haven't seen the full map yet. It's really cool, actually. And, you know, a bunch of people have been like, hey, have you seen the new map? Are you going to make a video about it? What do you think, you know, all the question marks are? I'd love to see your thoughts. And I've actually been planning this for a bit now. I've been working on it for a while, and I am excited to share with you guys what I do think are in all these question marks and stuff. So we're going to get into that in just a second. And I've been planning to do it. I've actually been working on it for a bit. I wanted to really think about it a bunch and you know, really give a real opinion on it and like actually fill it in and everything. And we're gonna jump right into doing that. And actually, we're gonna have graphics and everything on the screen. I worked pretty hard on this video, so I'm pretty excited about it. But we're gonna start right off the bat. We're gonna go in like a clockwise, or I guess I have to do it this way so you guys see it as clockwise sort of thing. So we're gonna go from top to right to bottom to left. And that's how we're gonna fill in all these question marks. So up first, we're gonna start with my favorite addition, who's quite obvious, and that is Odin, man. So Odin is just a character I've wanted in this game for just ever since I started playing, man. I think it's high time we have this guy in the game. We've had Odin's Vault, right? Bio Odin for years now. I don't know if he's going to be a playable character. I could see him like being like a boss, kind of like Maestro in a way, but just in one way or another, I'm so happy to finally have this guy in the game, man. And going along with Odin, I think that in group two, it is quite obvious that it's going to be Valkyrie or Brunhild. And the reason why I think that is because I believe it's Marvel Future Fight is currently adding her to the game. And whether it's the MCU version of Valkyrie or actually Brunhild from the comics, which is who Future Fight is adding, I'd be very happy to have the character in the game. I think she'd be a sick addition to the game. I could also possibly see this question mark being Hercules, but I don't think that Hercules would fit in there for Asgardians, because he's not an Asgardian, he's an Olympian. So I don't actually think that would work. I was having trouble finding out where I would place Hercules in here, actually, by the way, but we'll talk about that later. So up next, we're moving away from the Asgardians, and we're going a little bit more to the left first, and that is up there next to Black Panther Civil War. We have Shuri. Now, Shuri, specifically from the MCU, since Black Panther Civil War is a champion specifically from the MCU. So I feel like that little connection there just makes sense to me. So that's why I play Shuri from the MCU there. And up next, we have another MCU addition, which is Monica Rambeau. So this little girl from Captain Marvel, that is Monica Rambeau, who is related, or not related, but you know, connected on the map to Captain Marvel movie and also to Talos there as well. All right, so that's why I placed her there. That was my reasoning behind that. And up next, next to Talos, we actually have Marvel Studios Phase 4. So I have this picture here a couple places, just because there's going to be Captain Marvel 2. I believe we're going to have a new character, obviously, you know, based off somebody in the comics, but who knows who it's going to be. So I believe we're going to have like an MCU type champion, and you're going to see this sign, Marvel Studios Phase 4, pop up a couple times here throughout the video. So just know, like, obviously that's, you know, we don't know who that could be yet. We don't know what storyline they're gonna go down, whether it's Secret Invasion or something else. I feel like it'll probably be somebody either Kree or Skrull related. We'll have to find out in time, man, but that's always exciting. All right, so up next, man, we have, we're gonna move a little bit more to the right. Hold on 1 second here. Okay, we're gonna move a little bit to the right, and we have Null. So Null is a big character in the comics, man. I'm really excited to have this guy in the game. Finally, I think it's more than obvious that he's there, you know, with by the symbiotes, that's where he belongs. And there's one more little question mark next to the symbiotes. And, you know, I was thinking maybe like toxin, maybe anti-venom, but I see that this little thing isn't connected to venom. So what I thought about, I thought, first of all, a champion I think would be really sick to add to the game was Scream. So Scream is a symbiote. She's a female symbiote. I think it'd be really cool to have a female symbiote, because to my knowledge, we don't have any of those yet. We have Red Goblin, who's Norman Osborn, Symbiote Supreme, who's Doctor Strange, Venom the Duck, who's Howard, Venom, who's Eddie, and we have Carnage, who's Cletus Kasady, and Venompool, who's a mix of Venom and Deadpool. And then if we get Null, whether he's playable or not, it'd be cool to have a little bit more diverse selection of symbiotes as well. So I think Scream would be a really cool addition. I'm personally a really big fan of when they use much more obscure characters. Like, for example, when Darkhawk and Night Thrasher were added to the game, I was just so excited about those two, man. Because, like, I'm a big comic book reader, and when I see, like, you know, champions added that, like, I know that a lot of my friends don't know, and I get to talk to them about them and tell them about them, it's always really exciting for me. So I would love, as much as I'd love, like, Anti-Venom and Toxin and all of them, maybe Riot even as well, I would love to see Scream. That'd be really, really cool. But, of course, I'd be happy with the other ones I mentioned as well. So up next, we're going to jump down by the Fantastic Four, and I'm going to hide my face here in a second while we finish that. But up first, I don't have to do that yet, because there's a question mark that's connected to Annihilus and also Sue Storm, and I believe that person is going to be Blastar, who is another villain that resides a lot and it's connected with Annihilus and resides in the negative zone very often, and so he doesn't have too many connections to Sue Storm, and that's definitely a part of this that I did struggle with at first to make that connection. I'm gonna hide my face here for a second just so you could see the bottom here, but it just made sense to me since he has hung out a lot with Annihilus in the negative zone, and he is a villain from there, and he's more so connected towards Reed Richards, and you can see Reed's connected to Johnny, who's connected to Annihilus, who's connected to Blastar, and then who's connected down to Sue, and again, I that one throws me off a little bit, so it definitely might not be Blastar, but that is just who I came to the conclusion that I think that it is. So after Blastar, we do have a bit of a more obvious one. I don't think it's any secret at all that we are going to be getting Galactus, whether it be as a playable character or as more of like a boss or just an NPC, and I don't think he's going to be a playable character, but then again, we do have Dormammu, so at the end of the day, who knows, man? It's definitely possible, right? So we have one more question mark that's next to Galactus, right? And this, I feel like this, you know, it's very obvious that it would be Fire Lord. However, I'm actually going to go in a different direction here and say that it's going to be Plasma. Now, it's more than likely not going to be Plasma Man, but I just think it would be mighty cool if it was. I don't think that this is actually who this champion is going to be, but at the same time, man, I think it would be cool if we get a lesser known herald in the game as well. I mean, Airwalker is a bit lesser known for sure, but I feel like Fire Lord is so obvious to go there, and I think it'd be really cool if Plasma was added to the game. Again, another diverse female herald would be really cool to have in the game. Plus, she's pretty cool. I could see her having some really dope abilities, but I wouldn't be surprised if that's Fire Lord at all. I just don't think we need any more fire guys. I mean, we have Torch. Like, how different can Fire Lord be? I don't know. We'll have to see, man. But either way, that'll be a cool addition. More heralds, the better, to be honest. It's use them to, buff up Silver Surfer and everybody else. All right, so now we're going to move to the little question mark right to the left of the Contest of Champions logo, and you'll see it's connected to Sentinel. So for me, this was pretty obvious that it would be Nimrod. So Nimrod is I haven't read his comics for a while, but I believe he's like an Omega Sentinel from the future, and he hunts mutants just like Sentinel does, man. So this seemed like a pretty obvious thing to me, and that would be a really sick character to add, man. I just feel like Nimrod, I've always thought Nimrod would be a really dope character to add to the game, and I'd love to see him there. That's definitely who I think that is. Let's see here, and then if you look to the left of Colossus and to the right of Storm, you'll see a little question mark there, and for me, I think that this is going to be Cerebra, who is definitely a little bit of a lesser known character in the X-Men comics and everything. There was a run about 6 or 7, 8 maybe more, maybe like 10 years at this point, a while ago, where I forget the name of the team, but Colossus was on the team with Storm and also Wolverine, and Cerebra was there. So this for me was the closest connection that I could find to who would go right there. And I think that'd be cool. Cerebra's a pretty cool character, has some pretty cool abilities. I think that would be a good addition to the game for sure. And now if you go all the way to the left, you'll see Blade and also Bloodstone, and there are two there are two question marks that have the connection together, but aren't connected to anything else. Now, these are always a little tougher to figure out, but I thought about it for a while, and I do think that the first one is actually going to be Dracula. And the reason why is because there's, you know, Blade there, Vampire Hunters, and also Elsa, but not directly related to them, not directly connected, but just like in that realm as well. And with Dracula, I believe that's going to come Morbius as well. Now, I know that Morbius was like in that vote, and they were like, we don't have any of these guys planned, but who knows, man. I mean, I feel like those two being right near Elsa and Blade and also being connected on their own, I could see that definitely, I can see that definitely like being the connection there. And who knows, I could definitely be wrong, but that's, I spent a while thinking about that one, a very long time thinking about that one, because I just did not know for sure who that would be. There's really not too many ways to know for sure one like that, where it's not really connected. You don't have much to go off of. So speaking of connected and going off of things, you'll see that Morningstar is right there. And Morningstar is a Kabam original champion, and there's 1, 2, 3 question marks, all right? So for me, I know Elsa Bloodstone isn't a Kabam original, and she's connected, but for me, I believe that those three question marks are going to be Kabam original champions, which I'm all for, because if you look at that, Guillotine 2099 is there, and she's a Kabam original, and Kabam originals tend to be really good champions, so that would be really cool. And I believe Gabe, who works on the champions and everything, said that there are at least 3 Kabam originals, and for me, that just makes sense for them to go right there. But who knows, man, that's just that's what I would think for sure. But who knows, let's move on here. This is going to be another pretty obvious one for me. Connected to Punisher 2099, we have Spider-Man 2099 right above the little Kabam logo as well. I just feel like it's you know, long overdue to have this guy in the game. I mean, we have Guillotine 2099, which is a Kabam original, which was a very, I think she's a great champion, a great addition to the game, but for us to get an original 2099 champ before, you know, Miguel O'Hara was a little weird to me always at first, but it's definitely cool. And also Punisher 2099 as well before Spidey was always weird to me. But I feel like Spider-Man 2099 is by far the most notable champion or character from that universe. So it'd be really cool to get him in the game. And oh god, where was I? Here we are. All right, so I thought about this one a bunch too, and there's a connection between Miles and Spider-Man, and also it's in the Spider-Verse, and that could be a lot of different characters. But at the end of the day, I think that it's going to be Silk. More so for like selfish reasons, because I really want Silk in the game. I think she'd be a great addition to the game. There's a lot of Spider-Verse characters it could be. There's a lot of characters in that universe, man, and they're all connected through the web, right? So it could really be anybody, but I think Silk would be really cool, and that's personally who I want it to be. But yeah, man, let's see. So up next, there is 2 question marks interconnected again that are by themselves. And that's by the Defenders and above the Spider-Verse. And I spent a bit of time thinking about this one as well. And for me, I came to the conclusion that one of them is going to be Shang-Chi. Now, Shang-Chi, we are getting an MCU movie for Shang-Chi, right? Coming out in Phase 4 of the MCU. So for me, I believe that the one interconnected question mark next to Shang-Chi is actually going to be an MCU character that we don't know who it could be yet. You know, I don't want to try and I could spend some time thinking about like what the storyline could possibly be, but for me, I don't like to speculate the MCU movies too much. I like to go into it with a very fresh mind, so I don't want to speculate too much of like the MCU champions, but I do think it will be an MCU champion there, and that would make sense for him to be placed there as well. So yeah, that's who I definitely think is there. And we have a couple more here, and you'll see up top with Hyperion to the right, there is a question mark there, and it's very close to Yellow Jacket, but I don't believe that holds any significance at all. For me, I definitely think that this champion is going to be a much lesser known character that I'd be very excited to have, and that's Nighthawk. I can't say the word Hawk, I do it with Darkhawk too, but with Nighthawk, Hyperion was very good friends with Nighthawk, and he was also a Defender, and that's in the Defenders section. So for me, this is a bit of a no-brainer, as long as you are familiar with the comic lore there behind him and Hyperion. So I think he would also be a really cool addition to the game. He looks super dope. I don't think he would look like this in the game, but I think he'd look a little more modern. But I think he'd be a really cool addition as well. How long is this going? This is getting a little long. Let's just speed this up a bit. And up next here, we have, you'll see there is somewhere Where is it? Somewhere right below Nighthawk, you'll see Vision, Age of Ultron, and also Scarlet Witch. The OG Scarlet Witch, right? And you'll see that Vision, Age of Ultron is connected to the new Scarlet Witch, who's presumably, you know, from WandaVision. Who knows? We don't know, right? But there's also a connection between Scarlet Witch and Vision. Now, this could be a couple different things. This could be Vision's daughter. This could be, you know, a bunch of other characters. But I think this is going to be a character directly out of WandaVision, and who knows if that's going to be it, or if it's going to be Viz, we'll have to see. But I think, you know, thinking about it now, having Vision's daughter there does make a bit more sense, but it would, I don't know, because it would have to be like OG Vision. It wouldn't be Age of Ultron Vision. So I think I am going to stick with an MCU character here, which would be cool. And then up next we have, if you'll see, Domino and Gwenpool right under Hawkeye. Now, I came to the conclusion that I think that this is going to be Kate Bishop, but the one thing holding me back there is the fact that this little box is also not connected to Hawkeye, because that would make a lot of sense. But it makes a lot of sense with Gwenpool being connected to Kate. They were, you know, teammates on the West Coast Avengers about 2 or 3 or 4 years ago. But it would make a lot of sense to have Hawkeye connected to her as well. So I'm not entirely sure what's up with that. Maybe we're going to get another version of Hawkeye, like an MCU version of Hawkeye with the new TV show that they want to, you know, place another box next to. That's why she's not connected to OG Hawkeye, but I don't know. This could also be just a different character entirely, right? But yeah, so this is pretty much what my view or my expectations or predictions of what all the question marks would be. I have two more groups here that I made as well. I didn't really think too much about the Realm of Champions much because, you know, a lot of them could be either like original champions or more so related to that game. And I haven't played that game much at all yet. But there are two boxes that are out of the Realm of Champions bubble and going into the MCOC universe. So I went ahead and I put Ironheart here for the House of Iron connected to Iron Man. And again, I know that she was on the champion vote, and they said they have no plans for these champions yet, but this is a new graphic, and maybe they made the plans. Who knows, man? That's just where I would think that character would go. And in the similar of what I just said, I put Okoye here for the Kingdom of Wakanda. It just makes sense to me of that, you know, that's a place that she would fit in. But again, I do not know, and I wouldn't be surprised if it's something else. Who knows? Like, if you look down at Temple of the Vishanti there, we have Sorcerer Supreme and Storm X, right? And those are both coming out of the bubble. So, like, those are two types of champions that could be, you know, examples of, like, champions coming to MCOC from MROC. Who knows, man? I didn't think too much about who else would be in the middle, because there's five or six more question marks that are just by themselves, not actually connected. So it could really be any character, man, because that's a very new game and they have a lot of places to build on. It could be new houses entirely. Who knows, man? I was focusing more on the MCOC side of it. As you can see, I didn't place Hercules on here anywhere. I'm not sure where he would go, because I feel like he would be connected in a way to Thor, but I don't see any connections from Thor except from Odin up to that one question mark, who I thought was Brunhild, but that could very well just be Hercules. Who knows, man? Or he could be like, I could see Hercules being like in a bubble by himself and then eventually connect to Zeus. That would be really cool, but who knows, man? So this, I'm gonna hide my face here for the end. This is my prediction, right? So this is you know, who I would personally bet is what all these question marks are gonna be. Is it gonna be 100% right? Probably not. I'd say definitely not. There are a lot of question marks here, man, and a lot of different possibilities. But who knows, man? It could really be anything. I feel like some of them are very obvious, and some of them are a little bit more of a reach. Like, for me, Scream, right, and Plasma are two reaches for me, but that's what I'd be very happy to see. But anyway, my dudes, that's gonna be it for this very long video. I do hope you enjoyed it. I put a lot of work into this one, so if you did enjoy it, do your boy a favor and drop a like. Comment what you think some of these question marks are gonna be. Do you agree with this majorly, or do you disagree with this, like, vastly? So let me know that in the comment section below, and subscribe so you can eventually see some gameplay of these new champions, whether it be these guys or other guys, coming to you very, very soon. I'll be seeing you around.